Welcome to the fourth tutorial on electric power system. Here we are going to calculate the inductance of the transmission line. So the first problem is, if you have a single phase two wire transmission line which is 15 kilometer long, so the total length of the transmission line has been given to be 15 kilometer. It is made up of round conductors each 0.8 centimeter in diameter. So the diameter is given to be 0.8 centimeter and total length of the transmission line is given to be in 15 kilometers. They are separated from each other by 40 centimeters. So if you have two round conductors, the center to center distance between the conductor is 40 centimeter. You have to calculate the equivalent diameter of a fictitious hollow thin walled conductor having the same inductance as the original line and what is the value of this inductance. So you have to basically calculate the value of the inductance L. Now since we are dealing with the transmission line finding the inductance, so everywhere we are going to find the fictitious radius R dash, which is basically 0.7788 into R. And after finding the fictitious radius, we know the formula for the inductance for one conductor will be 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 ln of GMD by GMR. GMD by GMR. Now here in this case we use 2 for only one conductor, and if there are two conductors then we will use 4. So this is the basic fundamental of the finding the inductance of a transmission line having given the data. So let us see the solution. So the diameter of the conductor is given to be 0.8. So if you multiply it with 0.7788, we get a fictitious diameter 0.623. So this 0.623 is basically a fictitious conductor whose diameter is given to be 0.623. Now since we are having a loop inductance or a two conductor line, so we will be having 4 as the formula in the inductance, 4 into 10 to the power minus 7, and L is the total length of the transmission line, which is in kilometers, it is in 15 kilometers, ln of GMD by GMR. Now in this case it has been given that the two conductors are separated by a distance of 40 centimeter. So 40 centimeter is basically your GMD, that is the geometric mean distance, whereas the geometric mean radius you have to calculate using the fictitious radius R dash. Okay, so this after calculation with the appropriate unit, because most of the times we are having a unit of centimeter as well as kilometer, so convert it into an appropriate unit and then we get an answer of 29.13 millihenry. So the inductance of a 15 kilometer long line is 29.13 millihenry. We know that the inductance is generally given by millihenry per kilometer of the line. So per kilometer of the line, but here the question has been asked that for a total distance of 15 kilometer, what would be the inductance? So you have to multiply this with the total length of the transmission line. So this completes the first problem. Let us go into the second problem. In the second problem, you have a 7 identical copper strands conductor, each having a diameter R of shown in the figure. So the strands are made up of copper and total you have 7 strands, right? You have to find the GMR of the conductor, the geometric mean radius of the conductor. The total radius of each strand is given to be R. So the distance between the other conductor's strands you have to find. So basically what is the distance between D12, what is the distance between D13, what is the distance between D14 and so on. What is the distance between D23, D24, D22, D21, like that. you have to find. Only thing you have to consider here is that the distance D11 would be equal to your R dash, the distance D22 will be equal to R dash, and so on to D77 equal to R dash. Moreover, since the total number of conductor is 7, so you will, in calculating the GMR, you will be having 7 square possibilities, so it is equal to 49. So 49th root we will be having in finding the GMR. So let us see the solution. So for a 7 strand conductor, you have 49 possibilities, because there is 7 square is equal to 49, and all the distances whatever you have, the product of the distances for the 49th, you have to multiply. So L1 into L2 into L3, like this, all 49 possibilities will be there. Now, since the symmetry, there is a symmetrical in the nature of the conductor, what we can do is that instead of finding all the distances, we can use the property of the symmetry. So here we can see that we have the property of symmetry to the 6th power, 2r to the power 6th power, and r dash to the power 7th power. So in this way, we can basically find out the GMR of the conductor, so which is coming to be 2.177 into the radius of the conductor. So in this way, we can calculate the GMR for any geometry given to us, depending upon how many conductors are involved in that. So number of conductor, if n, then n square possibilities will be there. So n square root of the product of the possibilities will be the GMR of the conductor. Problem number 3, now we are going to deal with the ACSR conductor, aluminium conductor steel reinforced. So in the lecture class, we have discussed what is ACSR conductor is all about. Please look into the videos. So in the ACSR conductor, you will have the steel as the central strand, and it is surrounded with aluminium. So it is surrounded with aluminium. Now in this problem, it has been mentioned that when you have a 6 strand of aluminium, here we have 6 strands of aluminium and 1 steel, then it is totally making to be the 7 conductor strand. So the outside diameter is given to be 5.04 centimeter. The distance between the outside diameter, so the total distance of this is given to be 5.04 centimeter. Now the diameter of each strand, because all the strands are uniform, so the diameter of each strand is 1.68 centimeter. So all these strands are uniform in nature. So it is having 1.68 centimeter as the diameter. However, the diameter of this steel strand is not given to us, which we have to calculate from the geometry. Now, for a 50 hertz reactance at 1 meter spacing, it means this ACSR conductor is spaced with a distance D which is equal to 1 meter. It means the GMD, the geometric mean distance between the conductor, will be equal to 1 meter, correct? Now, the effect of central strand of steel has to be neglected, and advanced reason for the same, you have to find out what is the inductance of the line. So, we'll see how to find that. Now, the diameter of the steel strand we have to find out, because the outside diameter of the strand is given. So if you take the center, then the total distance this is basically 5.04. This total distance is 5.04. So if we subtract the two strand, then we are basically getting the diameter of the steel strand. So it is basically 1.68 centimeter, which we got after subtracting the diameter of the outside strands A and B. Okay, so we are getting the diameter of the steel strand. Next, using the geometry, we can find out all the distances which we have in the geometry of ACSR conductor. So ACSR conductor, we can see that the diameter of all the strands are equal along with the steel. So steel diameter is also 1.68 and the aluminium diameter is also 1.68. So having known that, we can find with the geometry like what are the distances involved in the ACSR conductor. So after that, we will see that there are 6 aluminium strand and 1 steel strand, but we have to neglect this steel given in the question. So you have 6 possibilities. So 6 square, you will have 36 materials involved in the GMD, GMD calculation, GMR calculation. So here 36 you are having as 6 square possibilities of your GMR calculation. So you have to find the GMR of the ACSR conductor. So all the possibilities you multiply and find out what is the GMR of the conductor is there. So you have find out that the GMR of the conductor is 1.93 centimeter. After that, we can find out the GMR of the conductor as 1.93 centimeter, and then we can have the inductance of the line. So inductance we can calculate in two different ways. Either we find for one conductor and then multiply it with the 2 into, this is the loop inductance. So loop inductance is equal to 2 into inductance of the per conductor. So it is basically 2 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 ln of GMD by GMR. So we have calculated the value of GMD, we have calculated the value of GMR. So just multiply and find out how much loop inductance is there. Okay, so here we can see that the loop inductance is coming to be 1.578, and the value of XL, that is the loop reactance, is equal to omega into L. So it is basically 2 pi F into the inductance that you have calculated. So the frequency is basically 50 Hertz. So this 50 Hertz, you can use it to find out what is the reactance of the loop, and you can get 0.495 ohms per kilometer. So here we can see that the length of the transmission line is not given in the problem. So you have to find out in per kilometer of the transmission line. Okay, this completes the problem. In the next problem, fourth, we are going to solve for a single phase transmission line. So here we have single phase transmission line, which is composed of 3 solid 0.25 centimeter radius wire, and the return circuit is composed of 2 0.5 centimeter radius wire. So we can see that the going wire is about 0.2 centimeter radius. So R1 is different from R2, that is the return radius is 0.5 centimeter. And there are 3 conductors which are involved in the single phase transmission line, the going conductor, and only 2 conductors are involved in the return circuit. So this is uneven, and then we have to calculate the inductance of the transmission line. So the GMR we have to calculate for 2 cases, one from X to Y and from Y to X. So when you do that, sorry, this is the GMD calculation, and this will be equal. When you go to X to Y or Y to X, it is equal, but the GMR calculation will be different because one conductor, one side is involving 3 conductor, other side is involving 2 conductor. So the GMR calculation will be different. In the geometry, it has been given that that separation is 6 meter between the conductors of side X, and from the side X to Y, the horizontal distance is 9 meter. So this is given in the geometry. So we have to calculate the inductance of the line. So other in the geometry, we have to find out the distance between these all possibilities. We can use what are the possibilities distances, sorry, not this, all the possibilities of these distances we have to find out in the GMD calculation. So the GMD between X and Y, so you have 3 conductors in X and 2 conductors in Y. So basically you will have 3 into 2 is equal to 6 possibilities of the distances in GMD calculation, right? So you will have 6 possibilities in the GMD calculation. to under root 6, and all the 6 possibilities you have to find from the geometry of the circuit. So after finding from the geometry all the 6 possibilities, you have to find out what is the GMD of the conductor, the 6th root. So it is getting 10.743 meter. So this is the GMD of the conductor between X and Y. Now, what is the GMR, geometric mean radius, for side X? Now, side X is involving 3 conductors. So you will have 3 square is equal to 9 possibilities of the GMR calculation. So all the 9 possibilities of distances you find out, multiply it to find the 9th root, you will get 0.481 meter. Now we have to find out for the side Y. So side Y is having 2 conductors, so 2 square is equal to 4 possibilities will be there. So all the 4 possibilities you multiply, you will get 0.153 meter. So we have find out the GMR of side X, GMR of side Y, and we have find out what is the mutual GMD, correct? So after finding the GMD, what you will do, you find the inductance of the side X separately, find the inductance of the side Y separately, add up, that will give you the total reactance of the line, right? So the inductance of X, here you can see, will you use 2 instead of 4 because only one conductor is involved. So ln of GMD by GMR of X. So GMR of X we will be using to find out the inductance. So this is the inductance for the side X. Similarly, here we will use the GMR of side Y. In finding the inductance of side Y, you will get 0.8503 into 10 to the power minus 7 as the GMR inductance of the side Y using the GMR of side Y, which 2 as the per conductor. Now add up the 2 inductances that you have calculated. So here you will get the loop inductance of the transmission line. So you'll get 14.715 into 10 to the power minus 7 Henry per meter. So this completes the problem where you are having uneven number of conductors in the going circuit and the return circuit. So you have to properly use the geometry to find the GMD and the GMR and solve the problems. Next problem. So problem number 1 to 4 we have discussed on single phase transmission line. Now problem number 5th is basically on 3 phase line. So 3 phase line we will be seeing, you know that in 3 phase line we can have either symmetrical spacing between the conductor or we can have unsymmetrical spacing between the conductor. So unsymmetrical spacing between the conductor, when we have, we generally do transposition that we have discussed in the lecture videos. Please look into that. Okay, so here you have 3 conductors or the 3 phase lines A, B and C. The distance between them is 1.7, 1.6, 1.6 and 3.2, which is not equal. It means the conductors are unsymmetrically placed with respect to each other. Then the conductor diameter is constant, which is 0.8 centimeter for all the 3 phases A, B and C. So you have to calculate what is the inductance of the 3 phase line. So first you calculate what is the GMR of the conductor. So GMR of the conductor is basically your R dash, which is equal to 0.7788 into the radius. So first you calculate from the diameter what is the radius and multiply it with 0.7788, you'll get the GMR, which is coming to be 0.003115 meter. So here we have used the units, SI unit as meter, so convert the centimeter into meter. Then the GMD of the conductor is basically the cube root, because 3 conductors are involved, into some product of the distances L1, L2 and L3, which is equal to 1.6, 3.2 and 1.6. So it will give 2.015 meter as the GMD of the conductor. So we have calculated both the GMR and the GMD. Now it will be very simple to find out the inductance of per kilometer. So 2 into 10 to the power minus 4 to convert it into your kilometer line. So you will have ln of GMD by GMR. So you can use the formula 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 ln of GMD by GMR to obtain in Henry per kilometer. So here we have obtained in millihenry per kilometer the inductance of the line for three phase transmission line. The next problem, we will be dealing with the bundle conductor. So we are going to find out the inductance of the bundle conductor. So bundle conductor, we have discussed in the lecture videos that we can have three possibilities. We can have two conductors or three conductors or the four conductors, which are placed in this fashion for the bundle lines. So here you have a three phase transmission line where two conductors are placed in the bundle. So two bundle conductors are there and the diameter is given to be 5 cm and the distances between the phases are given 6.5 and 6.5. So the distance between A to B is 6.5, B to C 6.5. So the distance between A to C you have to calculate, that you will get 13 m as the distance. Now for a bundle conductor configuration, you can see the 40 cm is given to be the distance between the individual strands of the bundle conductor, and the conductor diameter is given to be 5 cm. So here we have to calculate the GMD and the GMR to find the inductance of the line. The GMD calculation will be similarly to the previous problem where we have done cube root of the product of the distances L1, L2 and L3. Only difference will be there in the GMR calculation. In the GMR calculation, we have to calculate for the two conductor in a bundle. So the GMR calculation will be under root R dash into D, whatever you have for the two conductor specification. So here you are calculating the GMR DS and the GMD. GMD is similarly to the previous problem. We are finding the cube root of the product of the distances, which we are getting 8.19 m, and the GMR of the conductor for a two conductor bundle, we are getting 0.008825 m. So after calculating GMD and GMR, finding inductance is very easy. So you can directly use the formula 2 into 10 to the power minus 7 ln of GMD by GMR to find out the inductance of the line per kilometer. So you will get 0.906 mH/km per phase of the transmission line. So this completes the tutorial on finding the inductance of the transmission line. In the next tutorial, we are going to see the capacitance calculation for the transmission line. Thank you.